Welcome to Taskmaster, a pantomime of the pointless, a circus of the ridiculous, a ridicu-circus. And in this arena of anarchy, this big top of terror, I am your clinically obese ringmaster, and these are your clowns. It's Daisy May Cooper, Johnny Vegas, Catherine Parkinson, Mawan Rizwan, and Richard Herring. And to my left, a man who looks like a cylinder of meat that's been rolled across a hairdresser's floor. It's the human woolly kebab, little Alex Hall!
Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone.
I'm making it my mid-series resolution to be nice to you.
Oh, well, I could tell you a secret then, if you want.
Yes, please.
It's a side project I've been doing for quite a number of years. You're not allowed to tell them.
What?
I'm Banksy.
Cool. That is cool.
Do you believe me?
Yeah, he's not the person I was expecting, but why not?
Yeah. Does it change your opinion of me?
Nope. It's one of your strongest openers.
Yeah.
Well done. Let's crack on. Prize task, please.
Prize task, thank you. This week, they've been asked to bring in the best pointy thing.
Oh.
It's pretty simple stuff. Have you got a pointy thing? Yes. Is it the best pointy thing? Yes. Well done. Here's 5 points. And you might win it back at the end of the show if you carry on this winning streak, OK?
Right.
Good.
OK, Johnny, what is your pointy thing?
My pointy thing is brilliant and saves lives.
Mm. 5 points, looking good.
A meat thermometer.
Here's the meat thermometer.
I may have gone early with the 5 points.
Oh, come on.
I'd say you're around the 2-point mark at the moment, but try and talk it up.
Because it for novice chefs, for anyone, you've still got to feed your children, haven't you? And the last thing you want to do is give them raw meat.
Does everyone have a meat thermometer?
I haven't.
No, I haven't.
But then, as you can see, I largely eat processed food. I'd like one, I think, as some objet d'art. But one.
Well, I've actually brought in a self-help book.
OK.
Because it makes some great points.
No.
Yes.
It's called How to Get Your Point Across in 30 Seconds or Less.
All right. Well, talk me through, make some points.
I'll use some of the skills I learned to get my point across. The triangle technique.
Yep.
You got your content, delivery, form. I don't really know what it means, but it sounds good, you see?
You're all over the shop, mate. You're talking about a book that's got the word point.
Look at the corners. Pointy. You can hurt yourself in that.
Last place, I think. Who's next? Richard.
Yes. My pointy thing is a mask of that guy off of Hellraiser with the pointy face, with lots of points on his face.
Here he is.
Look at the number of points on that.
He's Pinhead.
Yeah. Disgusting old thing, isn't it?
It is. I wear that in bed with my wife. She likes it.
And do you keep saying, look at me, over and over again?
I think she likes it because it keeps my face away from her face. So there's...
Fair play to Richard. Yeah. It's not a bad pointy
it's
thing.
It's a pointy thing.
It's a lot very of points pointy. On that. Right, Daisy.
Yes.
Unbelievably leading in the series thus far, despite in this round having a consistently shocking record.
This could be the one.
You could really cement your place at the top of the pile.
I really
with
could.
Something imaginative and different.
Kebab stick.
Ah, right.
It's a kebab stick.
I tell you why.
Right.
Because it doubles up as a javelin for a Sylvanian family. And I don't know if you've ever tried to hold an Olympic event with Sylvanian families, but you cannot. Buy javelins for him.
Here is the javelin slash kebab stick.
Oh, God. It's literally like you remembered there was a task and you just fell into your drawer.
Well, it's a pointy thing.
Catherine, can you beat the laziest person in the room?
I don't have that much confidence in this one, particularly after you've shown Richard's, because mine is also a mask, but it's only got 1 point.
It's a Venetian mask.
Is it?
It's more attractive than Richard's. It looks like this.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, OK.
This one protects the wearer's identity during promiscuous or decadent activity.
That's... Yeah, I look at that and I just see Tom Cruise holding onto his mammy.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, it's a pointy mask.
Like that. I really had
thought of doing sat-nav as a pointy thing, which I think might have been a better choice.
I like that.
So you got a book, two pointy masks,
yep,
and a couple of sticks over here.
Putting my wand last. Yeah, sorry.
1 point.
She put in a metal stick.
That's pointy.
There's no justice. 2 points. Sylvanian fall into a draw, girl.
OK, in third place...
Meat thermometer.
Meat thermometer man, 3 points.
Yeah, saves lives, good try.
So it's the battle
and
of the masks.
And it's a choice between the masks.
Yes.
The honest truth is that I just instinctively like the image of Richard Herring sitting in bed wearing that mask.
Fair enough.
So I'm going to give Catherine 4 points.
Fair enough.
And Richard, thank five.
You. Richard Herring wins the first title.
I needed it.
Tusky, tusky.
Yesy, yesy. Baggy, baggy. Hi, Daisy.
Hello.
Hello.
Right, Alex.
How are you?
I'm a bit cold.
Cold?
Yeah.
Where's your big coat?
Oh, I suppose I could wear a coat.
That's for Christmas trees.
Yes.
Bag the heaviest thing from the furthest distance.
Your attempt ends when you have bagged an item.
Highest score wins.
Your score is the weight of the bagged object in grams multiplied by the distance from the bagging machine in centimetres.
You have 20 minutes.
Your time starts now.
The bus walk going!
Oh, God.
Have you two considered doing a double act of some kind, you and Catherine? Because the banter between you instinctively knew she was cold. She confirmed she was. You suggested she could have worn a coat, and she confirmed yes. Had she previously thought of it, she wouldn't have worn a coat.
Then we left.
And I was like, what the fuck? I don't know what you're going to do next.
Wait and see.
Hey, I like the idea of this task.
Your sort of thing, isn't it?
It is my sort of thing. And I often go past those Christmas tree things, and I think, I wouldn't mind popping myself.
Well, this is long-distance bagging.
Right, bag it up, baby.
Bag it up, baby. We're going to start with my wife, sure. Daisy, and, yes, yeah, sod it, why not? Also, Richard.
Lovely. Mm.
So what I'm going to do is fill this up with really heavy things, and then I'm going to stand on a ladder, I think, and then get, a tube or something.
What's the heaviest thing I could weigh it with?
So you're going to send it down a zip wire?
Yes, basically.
What sort of a case is it, Richard?
It's a trumpet.
I'm going to make a rice tunnel.
A rice tunnel?
Yeah. Rice rocket.
Do you want me to cross out rice tunnel?
Yeah, rice rocket.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Won't shut unless it's in the actual shape of a horn.
How's the bag going over that sledge?
Yeah, it's not going to work.
You've got 9 minutes.
Come on, so slow.
You're throwing from there?
I think I'll go from here. We'll try it from here.
Okay, front foot.
One, two... That was too far away.
What's in the bag, Daisy?
Bricks.
Oh, that's heavy, that. What even is that?
It's a boat winch.
A boat winch?
Winch.
One, two.
What number are you trying to get to?
OK, ready.
Put down a measuring bowl.
Good luck.
Good, isn't it?
There's like a little rope thing, yeah.
I could do a run up. Wah! Wah!
That was almost the closest. Do you want me to let go?
Yep. Fuck! That's not going to work.
Bend your knees. It's really heavy.
Whoa!
Might just throw it in.
Yeah?
I think so. Ready, steady. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Milan.
Okay, Merry Christmas.
Are you going to weigh it now?
Yes.
Oh!
That is heavy, right?
Yeah. Congratulations, Richard.
Thank you.
Yeah. Lovely bagging. Lovely bagging.
Someone was excited to show off his big scissors, wasn't he?
They were so big.
Milan, you came good with that old Christmas classic,
yeah.
The rice rocket. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what part of your brain you accessed that idea from.
I was just thinking, like, aerodynamic.
Rice?
But rice.
It was very heavy. It was very, very heavy.
Daisy, I always think if you want to throw something the furthest distance through an aperture that's directly in front of you, it's all about trajectory.
I was thinking that the distance I could do in height. No?
It's a complete collapse of common sense. Richard, you went old school with the classic horn case full of pebbles. What I was noticing was that you were taking a run at it.
Yeah, but I was running towards my mark.
OK.
You know, so like when people are throwing javelins, they don't just go...
There was some...
They go, wah! Yes.
You're quite right, and I was going to come on to wah,
yeah.
Which on the pebbles in a horn case circuit, you're known for the wah.
Wah, yeah.
Yeah. Let's have some statistics.
Well, there's going to be some big scores, because it's centimetres times grams, mawan. 3 metres away, 3.05 metres away.
That's good, isn't it?
It weighed 8.6 kilograms... So the score is 2.623 million.
Wow!
The population of Birmingham.
I get 2.6 million points.
Yeah.
No, that's your score. They don't translate to points.
2.6 million.
That's his score. Centimetres times grams. Richard, from 2.7 metres, 15 and a half kilograms, you get a score of 4.1 million, the population of Rome.
OK.
Daisy, 18.2 kilograms, but it didn't make up from the distance. She was very close.
Very, very close.
Yeah.
I mean, the only thing of merit in the whole text, yet again, was her use of the word fuck.
Daisy, the population of Bucharest, just 1.8 million. So you're in last place at the moment, because you were very close to the machine.
It's the end of part one. You've just got time to reflect on the bad decisions you've made in life before we come back to distract you. Off you pop! Taskmaster, where our cast were using a Christmas tree bagging machine way out of season.
Yes, so it was nice and affordable. It's Catherine and Johnny now.
Is it mad to suggest myself?
Biggest thing. Oh, sugar and spice.
What have you got there, Johnny?
Oh, I've got a table! Ow!
I will probably be heavier than the cow.
You think you're heavier than that cow?
The cow's hollow and I'm not.
Can I go out the gate?
Why do you want to go out the gate?
Cos I was thinking of hitting someone over the head and putting them in there.
Practically, I think I'd be easier to bag.
Yeah, I think there's a few problems with the cow.
How much time, Alex?
11 minutes.
Please, come here. Would you do me a massive favour? I've got to win a task. Would you let me wrap you like a Christmas tree? Please!
I've got to be at work at 12.
No, you'll be there by 12. It'll take 1 minute.
Maybe lift up the blanket, cos I'll be lying on that.
Right, so if you just climb in and then I'll attach things to you.
OK.
So if anyone asks, you're a robot. Ready?
Yeah.
OK?
Sure.
Are you ready?
Yeah, right.
The launch begins.
God. Oh, that's quite nice.
All right.
Mm, can you avoid that
bit? Yeah, I'm going to watch that bum.
Yep.
I'm going to find something else that I can attach to your shoelaces.
OK.
I seem to remember you telling me that you played the banjo.
You say when to...
I haven't got a plan. I'm going to just see when we get there.
Well, we're nearly there.
Right. You might be late for work.
Just think this through.
Right.
Right.
I put you down?
Yeah.
You're definitely okay with microwave, though.
You're not fully through yet. Forty seconds left, John.
Right, ready?
Yeah.
No. I'm coming. Right. I just need that angle.
Are you able to wiggle yourself?
I just suddenly had a moment of wondering what I was doing.
We done?
Okay, I'll just sort of flip out, yeah?
Okay.
A little bit more.
Okay, I'll measure that distance and can I get a weight?
I am 22 stone.
22?
Thereabouts, yeah.
Same as Greg.
And 4 pounds.
Thank you very much, Catherine.
Thank you.
Confounded our expectations that Catherine and I are exactly the same weight.
I wouldn't say that. She's definitely shorter than you.
I genuinely am 22 stone.
She must be very dense. Very dense.
Heavy boned.
Yeah.
She started 33 metres away from the machine. Was it all one movement, do you think, Greg?
Did she touch the floor?
She did not touch the floor between the launch and the mounting and the penetration.
Oh, for God's sake.
I mean, it's going to be massive, this score, isn't it?
Well, if we're including 33 metres and 22
which,
stone...
Which we are.
Then it's the population of Tokyo and Bangkok combined.
Oh.
It's Tokycock. It's 47 million.
It's a big one. Well done. Johnny, it was a bit when you convinced that man to come in. You convinced Matthew to come in. And the worst of it is that when he got to work and explained why he was late, he would definitely have been signed off sick. Johnny Vegas put me through a Christmas tree. He's been under a lot of pressure, this poor guy.
Getting him in didn't take that long, but getting him out took quite a while.
Well, I mean, this score's going to be...
Are you saying he started the bagging process from the gate?
Yeah. That's the distance where the object came from.
He brought the object from the gate.
I don't think you can count, like, the distance it travels before you start throwing it.
So where are you saying that Matthew was thrown
from? I say he was thrown from the 0 metres.
I mean, he's got a good point. I think we'll take it from 10 centimetres away, but we'll count all of the objects that went through with him.
In which case, he gets a score of 1 million and comes last.
OK.
What?
Because it was only 10 centimetres.
Why were you so easily swayed by that? And he didn't.
It's me or Vegas.
Well, OK, and what would have happened to him if I'd have thrown him? It's not
that's why you couldn't... Because otherwise you could just say, I'll go and get a 5,000-tonne weight.
It's not
and get some people to carry me and put it in a wheelbarrow.
No, I'm standing by it. It's fair.
I'm officially sulking.
OK. How long will that last for? Nah, seconds.
Shut up.
Right, come on, let's have some scores.
Well, the scores are, then, Johnny gets 1 point, Daisy gets 2 points, Mawan 3, Richard 4, but Catherine, with her 47 million, gets 5 points.
I'm yes, crazy. Please.
Right, quick scoreboard.
Do you want to hear the series scores, Stefan?
Yes.
Well, Mawan has crept into last place with 55.
Oh,
Catherine
Mawan.
No longer last with 56. Johnny, 63. Richard, 68. Daisy still in the lead with 71.
Whoa.
Somehow. And today, the scoreboard is very satisfying for me. We've got 3 people on 4 points and 2 on 9. It's Catherine and Richard in the lead with 9 points.
Another one.
OK, another task. Here we go.
Hey, Alex.
Welcome to the garage.
Gorgeous.
No doubt what lies in this envelope will put me off porcelain for life.
Paint a picture of a howling wolf on this teapot.
You may not touch the teapot or remove it from the turntable, and you may not tamper with the turntable or its power. The turntable will see...
Oh, you mispronounced a word there.
The turntable will keep speeding up until you have named 20 American states.
Oh, you're joking. It's not a strength.
If you do name 20 American states, this turntable will slow down. You have 10 minutes.
I'm not reading it, cos I know what happens when I read
it. You have to read it. It's the one rule.
Your time starts now.
Lovely.
Mm.
We all get it. Let's start.
Let's just start with Richard and Mawan.
Your time starts now. Arkansas.
Is that how you pronounce it?
California. I don't know. Arkansas.
Alaska. Oh, shit, man, I'm so bad at multitasking.
Vermont, is that one?
Yes, I'll give you Vermont.
South something.
Massachusetts.
Say that one more time.
Massachusetts.
New York. I used to be able to do all of these in alphabetical order.
Illinois.
South Dakota, North Dakota.
Yes.
Shit, I know more than I thought.
How many do you think you knew?
New York, LA. That's two, write that down.
Florida.
Oh, yeah.
New Mexico, New Hampshire.
You haven't named the main one yet.
What's the main one? Detroit?
No, I can't give you that.
Detroit is one.
It's harder than you think. Alaska, Hawaii.
Chicago, West Philadelphia, born and raised. Philadelphia?
Is that New Jersey?
No, it's the same as usual.
OK.
New Jersey.
OK. I got New Jersey.
You're distracting me and I'm seeing
okay,
right through
sorry.
It.
Sorry.
Oh, so Illinois. Indiana, Arizona, so Washington's up there.
Hawaii, Texas. Why'd you cross it out? Oklahoma City, Dallas, Salt Lake City's in Utah. Where's Disneyland?
Paris. One left. Still haven't said the main one.
Maine.
It's South Carolina.
That took you 3 minutes. Not bad.
Okay.
It will gradually slow down now.
What does a wolf look like?
Look at that. See, that looks like a wolf, doesn't it? And on the other side, I was going to draw a wolf from Gladiators. I'm happy with that.
Stopping there?
Yeah.
Don't blame you.
I'm done. Less is more, isn't it?
Very good.
Here we go.
Did you put wolf on?
I did wolf on the other side.
Yeah, lovely dated yeah. reference.
Thank you.
Do you know who Wolf from Gladiators is?
No.
Of course
I'm
you
not.
Don't.
I'm not.
Of
old.
Course you don't. He's a pensioner. Some far more up to date references from you. The old Fresh Prince. That's what the kids are all into now, isn't it?
You want to see someone else painting?
Yeah.
We're now going to look at Daisy and Johnny and Catherine painting.
Let's do it.
Right, I'm just going to go and paint it because I won't be able to name 20 American states, I'm pretty sure.
You don't want to name the main state?
Which is obviously Florida.
Okay.
Arkansas.
California.
Good.
Texas. Oh, what's a really cold one?
My wife knows them.
Could you ring her?
Yeah, I'll ask her.
Wisconsin.
Venezuela.
I can't give you Venezuela, Johnny.
OK.
Washington. New York.
Correct.
OK, New York.
I like your jumper. Is it a jumper or a jacket?
It's a velvet jacket.
I got a New Jersey for Christmas.
Oh.
Jersey.
What sort of jersey?
I want to say royal.
Not royal jersey, no.
Jersey, New Jersey.
Correct.
It just looks like that cat that shits in my yard every night.
Mississippi.
Mississippi!
Correct.
Kentucky. Okay. Alabama. Boston.
No. I had a whole pizza for lunch.
The whole thing?
Mm-hmm.
Ohio.
Ohio!
Oh!
That's a state, isn't it?
Lovely.
See, I actually think it's better because it's moving.
Where's Yellowstone Park? Nevada. Montana. Virginia. Whoa.
Oh, God, I've added another ear in a moment of panic.
Kansas!
Yes?
And I think I'm finished.
Wait, quick!
Oh! I think about 5 minutes ago it was better, but that's fine.
It's probably some of the best work I've ever done.
You see, Catherine's so locked into the banter that you crazy cats have together now. Even when you're dropping her hints, she'll just run with it and say, yes, it's a velvet jacket. Johnny and Daisy is the most poised I've seen both of you.
Yeah.
And Daisy was very close, got to 18.
Oh, that's very really good.
So you've got to judge them. We'll put them all up as one. This is Daisy's wolf.
Do you see? It's howling at the moon. And it's a dark night, so we know it's the moon. I did some decoration on the top, but that might be a nosebleed that the wolf's got.
Johnny's, the wolf on the right, and he said on the left, it's a squirrel who scratched his own eyes out.
Right. I think it, on the right, it looks like a grizzly bear. I think it's a good grizzly bear.
I remember more detail with the eyes and the blooded mouth.
For an artist, it's certainly disappointing.
Do we have a look at Catherine's?
Yes, please. Right.
Oh, see the word howl.
That to me looks like what depression looks like.
The old howling wolf.
Yeah, a howl and a dark, dark cloud. Oh, that's a shame. Next.
Moan.
Oh, it's lovely. Who's this? It's mine. Wow. It's like the thing from Stranger Things.
I mean, it looks like a creature, at least.
And then finally we see a wolf and the wolf on Richard's one. Definitely Wolf from Gladiators.
Not bad, is it?
And he's howling.
Oh, man. In last place, it's the dark cloud of depression that is Catherine.
Catherine gets 1 point.
That's right. 2 points. Moan.
Moan gets two for the large blob.
The trained artist and drawer of bears. Johnny gets 3 points.
3 points for Johnny, third place. Daisy or Richard for 5 points.
I'm going to give them both 5 points.
Wow. Ooh, for the first time, 5 points to Daisy and Richard.
They don't deserve it. OK, it's time for Alex to salute the end of part two whilst doing a sexy hula dance.
Is it sexy enough?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Hello again. Welcome back to Taskmaster. Time for a new task, I should say.
Yes, I should say too. And this one is a homework task.
Hello.
Johnny.
Alex.
Alex one. The task is in your pigeonhole.
OK.
Do you know where your pigeonhole is?
No, no one's told me. Oh, this thing that said Moan on it.
Yeah. Oh. Do something out of character with this £20.
None of us are. Most out of character thing wins.
I won't tell you what's just come to my mind.
You have 3 months. Your time starts now.
3 months?
What would be in character for you, Daisy?
Vaping. Or ghost hunting.
I thought of drugs.
Drugs?
But I'm not going to do that.
What sort of drugs?
I don't know. Poopers. What are they called? Ploppers. What are they called? Poopers. Poppers.
Are you talking about the... Are you talking about the drugs or the people that provide the drugs?
I don't know.
Right, so it's most out-of-character thing. They are £20 in 3 months.
It's difficult for me. I'm going to have to judge it on how well I know them from this experience.
Yes, you are. Do you want to see what Johnny sent us?
Yes, please.
This is how he spent his £20.
I mean, I've been meaning it. Shave it down.
OK, nice support. Yeah.
Sorry.
Nice and tight. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Was that it? That's all you got? You've got a T on your chest.
Not just a T.
TM.
A TM, as you can see here.
I got Taskmaster.
Yeah.
And what about the armpits?
Yeah, the armpits was completely unnecessary to the effect.
Here's the thing, though. If someone said to me, you know Johnny Vegas, he's he's had his armpit hair taken off and TM waxed into his chest, this would be my face.
Really?
Yeah.
No, but visiting a beautician or anything like that.
That is a good point. You're back in the game.
OK, Catherine now. Catherine now.
Catherine, interesting.
So she took her £20 somewhere and then took this photo outside a bank.
I don't know why I'm doing that position.
And then after she went into the bank, she looked like this. She deposited the £20 in the bank.
I mean, that is exactly what I would think you would do with
Don't know me very well.
I clearly don't. Because I imagine you are frugal and you do look after the pennies.
I don't know how I have given that impression.
Catherine, can I confirm you did definitely deposit that money in the bank?
The truth is, I didn't put that £20 in the bank. I spent it.
which I think confirms...
The out-of-character thing was lying about putting it in the bank.
Oh, that's quite good.
Ah! I'll mull on that.
OK, you mull on that.
Yeah.
Daisy May Cooper...
Hello.
..invested her £20, similarly, on a subscription. It was portable restroom operator.
And I tell you why this is most out of character, because I actually thought about this one.
Yeah, normally you get out of bed and fall into your kitchen, whatever your hand lands on, right?
Yeah. Is that out of character?
What, for her to buy a magazine?
I think that's quite offensive.
I can see you hanging out by the Portaloo quite a lot at a festival.
Absolutely not.
It's a big leap.
I can never be bothered to queue for the fucking Portaloo. Just shit
yourself.
So that's completely out of character.
I know that Pro Magazine have a policy of their cover model is always just about to have a shit. When you open the cover, is there another picture of him afterwards? Very good. Who's
okay.
next?
Richard.
Yeah.
Who paid a visit to a special person, didn't you,
Richard? All right.
Did, yeah.
OK, let's have a look. So you're a man who likes to be in control, Richard, and you see yourself as very logical.
Can you see how I'm going to do in the competition? Can you work that out?
Let me see. Well, you're going to be happy with the result.
OK.
I'm not sure you're going to win, but if you don't, it's going to be close.
Well, so I usually come second. That's what usually happens when I'm in these
circles. Oh, right.
So that sounds like it's going to be business as usual.
I hope that's been interesting.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Thank you.
And it was really lovely to meet you.
And you, Jenny. Thank you very much.
Great. Good luck, right. darling.
You seem to quite enjoy it, though.
But it's out of character. It doesn't matter. You can try something out of character and discover that you've entered a new beautiful world of mysticism and tarot.
And why is it out of character?
Because I don't believe in any of that bullshit. And I would never pay anyone...
Right. Finally, Mohan Rizwan. What did you do, Mohan?
Well, it's a qualification in how to deal with aggressive people at work.
This is the gift voucher he got. It's from the New Skills Academy. Pick any 10 lightning skill lessons from the list below for only £20. Save £470.
That is a big discount.
Completely true.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, let's try. Do you want me to be aggressive?
Yeah, sure. Okay.
I hate your trainers.
OK. OK, well, I'd like to say, no, Greg.
Yes.
I am a valuable member of this team. I'm assertive, I'm creative, I'm powerful, I'm beautiful, I'm a sexy badass bitch. I added that last bit from the subject. And I think the others would agree that we will not stand for this.
And that was £2 worth, of course, that one.
I do feel a bit less aggressive.
Right. Can I score it?
Right, I'm going to give Catherine a generous 3 points because I thoroughly enjoyed the fact that she's obviously spent a few raves off a nut on the old poop.
So 3 points to Catherine.
Yeah, in joint second place, both getting 4 points, I'm going to put Johnny and old Richard the psychic.
OK, waxing and tarot both get 4 points.
That's right. And in the number one slot, it's the poo-obsessed Daisy and the bad boy turned good, Mohan.
The winners are Mohan and Daisy! Hey.
Another task, please!
Just like a girl I went to school with, this one's Melanie.
Why does this fill me with dread?
Hello, team.
Hey, Alex.
Hi.
Hi, Alex.
Does everyone like what they see?
I'm liking it.
Who's going to read this one?
Shall I? Yeah.
That was beautifully done, by the way. Oh, God.
Eat the most watermelon.
The watermelon must not leave the lab. You must be wearing a boiler suit and safety goggles when you're eating the watermelon.
You must stay on your platform at all times. You must not feed yourself. You must only eat the watermelon that is on your platform.
You must not feed yourself. You have 4 minutes. Your time starts now. Shall we get dressed?
How long have we got?
4 minutes.
Oh, God, that's going to be this.
I've got massive boots on.
Mm. Pretty straightforward. They've got to feed each other loads of watermelon.
Yes. One team was filmed before social distancing and one the other. First of all, we're going to see Dickie and Daisy.
The double Ds.
Oh, lovely quirk.
All right, that's pretty good. There's a big bit there.
I'll tell you what we could do. I hold that to you.
Yeah.
And you hold that to me.
Keep it down. Try not to spit on the one I'm eating. Let's try enough. I'm like the Walking Dead. There's a nice bit there that I can put on a plate for you. How long have we got left?
You've got 50 seconds.
Oh, 50 seconds.
Things I've ever seen in my life. It was like Daisy was consuming Richard.
I mean, Daisy did most of the consuming, there's no doubt about that.
He didn't really eat. He was just kind of watching me, which makes me think you were turned on by it.
I mean, they got the job done. The watermelon originally weighed 8.6 kilograms.
Right.
There was only 7.6 left in the room, and some of that had been down. So they ate at least 1 kilogram, which is a whole pineapple or a toaster in 4 minutes.
Listen, you can stay and watch the last part of the show after these adverts, but then I want you to brush your teeth and go straight to bed, OK? And no, it isn't a good idea to have a bowl of cereal this late. Part of the show, and we're right in the thick of a watermelon task.
Daisy and Richard got intimate, now complete with lengthy grabbers. It's the dynamic trio.
Right, so we've got to feed each other.
Who's feeding who?
So if I
feed me,
if I feed more on his,
you pick up a piece of mine. We all put it 12 miles at the same time.
Okay.
Picking.
Getting a slice.
Getting a slice.
Oh, it's heavy, you know. Approaching the mouth, Johnny.
Approaching the mouth. Are you ready? Are you?
Good, good job, Johnny.
Come on, Catherine, I'm hungry.
Sorry.
I'm going to be shitting pips for a week.
Oh, my gosh, it's so heavy.
Trust you.
Johnny, I can't eat and do this at the same time.
You can, just trust me.
I'm quitting it, Johnny. That one's going to fall.
Oh, you took it, God.
Enjoy.
Right. No, this is a good... And it's a little beast.
Oh!
Sorry.
You can do this.
This is out of purpose.
You can do it. Come on.
Right.
Come on, move outside. I know, it's a really good piece.
I'm just going to guide it in. Good job.
Right, look at that.
You've decimated your... He's eaten so much of it.
I want Daddy's watermelon. You guys just make it weird.
Thank you, team.
It says something that, in context, that looked like tea at the Ritz. By comparison to what we've already seen, that was three people having a perfectly civilised meal. Did they eat much?
Well, they ate the equivalent of a human heart or 16 mice. They ate 331 grams.
OK.
I think arguably a lot harder for that team.
A lot harder for that team, but there were three of them to munch on melon, so I'll give 3 points to the distance feeders.
And
5 full points to the worst thing I've ever seen on television.
5 points to Richard and Daisy.
Right, please head up to the stage for the final task of the show. What's happening here, then?
Johnny Vegas is going to read the task.
Here we go. Say the most different words without hesitating for more than 2 seconds. Any words already said will not count. The person who says the fewest words each round is eliminated. The person in last place goes first.
You can do this task one at a time, whoever's standing on the speaking circle. You've got to say as many words in a row as possible. But in round one, they all have to be 3 letters long. And if you pause for more than 2 seconds, that's the end of your go. Mawan is currently last, so you're going to go first. So, Mawan, please come to the speaking circle and everyone else move around. Good luck, Mawan. 3-letter words. If you pause for more than 2 seconds, that's the end. Good luck.
Cat, hat, fat, tat, lat, sat, bat, chat.
Lat, very clever, using the lat.
Yeah, I just know shit.
Which means 7 is the score to beat. Please move around. Ooh. Johnny, come to the speaking circle. If you get over 7, you're through to round 2.
Ant, mop, tea, and...
That was more than 2 seconds. 4.
4.
4. Currently, Johnny is in danger, Greg.
Yeah.
Catherine, come to the speaking circle.
See, I think you're going to be good at this.
You'd be wrong. Was, vat, van, nip, knit, are, our, top, lop, cop, ran, bat.
I can't give you back, but that is 11.
Told you.
She has ruled out a lot of words for these guys.
You know me better than I thought.
Lovely work.
Daisy, come to the speaking circle. 4 or more.
See if she knows words the way she knows a way round a melon.
Loo, poo, wee, ma, ram, scar, tar, la. Scar is in S-K-A. Yeah.
Scar the music.
Yeah.
7, I think, from Daisy. Daisy, you're through to round 2. Richard, please come to the speaking circle. It's the final player in round 1, Greg.
Yeah.
Richard Herring.
I think he's going to do well.
He's in the lead at the moment.
Yeah.
Can he get more than 4? Good luck, Richard.
Zip, zap, zoo, why, dug, like, dig, dog.
Richard is through to round 2. We've lost Johnny Vegas, I'm afraid.
Oh.
So,
Johnny, do you mind staying up here with us anyway?
And yes, because I love to cry in front of other people.
And if you could just put one hand over your mouth, that'd be great for the rest of the game.
Oh.
OK, we're on to round 2. It's 4-letter words. Mawan, please come to the speaking circle and everyone move around.
Loads of 3 ones lined up.
It's 4-letter words now. Good luck, Mawan. Your time starts.
Bear, care, rope, zing, can, leaping.
Well, you started saying leap, but then you said leap.
No, I said leap. I was starting another word.
Pigs.
No.
We saw your sneaky little glance back then.
Oh, please. I never went to university. I couldn't afford it.
We're stopping. Yeah. Can I just confirm, your bear, was that B-A-R-E or B-E-A-R?
B-E-A-R.
Very important. OK, he scored 5. Good luck, Catherine. 4-letter words, starting...
Bear, look, book, took, nook, rook, deer, tear, wear, fear, leer, rear, mere, peer.
Well, that's 14. She's through to round 3. Daisy, if you get more than 5 4-letter words, you're through to round 3 with Catherine.
Wank, fuck, shit, bums, tits, cock, task, mask.
9. Daisy and Catherine are definitely through to round 3. Can Richard join them? Richard, come to the speaking circle. There are no more swear words left, as far as I know. Good luck.
4, 5, tour, your, acre, cat.
Stop there on 6. Greg,
yep.
That gap was 2.5 seconds.
Oh.
Which means they've both got 5.
They're both out, I'm afraid.
They're both out in joint third.
No!
And we have our two finalists.
Believe it.
Catherine Daisy, please step onto the golden circles of final.
Oh.
Johnny, two very different approaches so far.
Okay, so it's Catherine to go first. 5-letter words.
Beard.
Fanny.
Faded.
Cox.
Weird.
Wanks.
Farted.
Shit.
We cannot give you farted. It is 6 letters.
Unbelievable! Unbelievable! May Cooper crashes through! No one expected that. Come back down, we'll add all that up. We'll see what the final scores are.
Yeah, so Johnny got 1 point there. Moana and Richard got 3 points each. Catherine 4, but Daisy was a winner with 5 points with all those lovely words. And that does mean she's now the series leader by 6 points on 91. What? But would you like to know who's won this week's episode, Greg?
More than anything.
Well, with a score of 26, he's pipped Daisy to the post. It's Richard Herring!
Whoa! Richard wins. Go and pick up your pointy things.
Hello, Richard.
So, what have we learned today? Fruit farmers, if you're struggling following Brexit to find staff to harvest your crops, get Daisy May Cooper a subscription to a toilet magazine and she'll clear a field of melons in 10 minutes. See you next time for more fun times. But right now, here's tonight's winner again, Richard Herring!